talking. Oh, I got these headphones in my ear. So that I just ran back that little bit of talking video that I did. And it was real low. So I put the headphones in the ears and talked through them so that when I upload it to YouTube, y'all will be able to hear me. Because I got some videos. I just don't want to delete them. That is really low. Fill my plate. All right, so I'm back. So now I was talking about who I were, I am rather, not were, who I am. I just stuck in my ear, so I'm gonna pull it out of it. So I can like, I feel like I'm like, disconnected. All right, so, we are talking about what I got on. Okay, so, my rings. That I was saying, I was going to mix up the ring. So I got these two rings from Pandora. Okay. And I was supposed to go back. Oh. Just brought back. This ring brought back to my attention what I wanted to point out about people not judging the book by its cover. Now I went, me and my daughter went into Pandora, and I'm trying to think, I think it was in KP. Because the setup was different, so I know it was in downtown Brooklyn, in Atlantic Mall. Ooh, it was hot. So. We went in there, we was waiting on the line, and there was this, I'm not being racist or nothing, but there was this darker tone young lady there. So you know our people, you know, we just seem to always have attitudes. We seem to always want to initiate that we're smart. I don't know whether it's an ancestor thing. It's a slavery thing, and just like I was telling somebody, you weren't in slavery. Maybe your grandparents was, or their parents was, but you weren't. Be thankful that they made it through, and if they didn't, you're here today to speak of freedom for them. So why sit back and be mad with a white person because of the simple fact that of what happened many years ago, and a lot of people may not like what I'm saying, but just like I said, I look at things on a spiritual level, and Jesus came to free us from slavery. And so if y'all worrying about something that happened back in the 1900s, okay, when we weren't even thought about, just think about 2,000 years ago, the stuff that was going on where God had to send his son to come and die so that we can be free. And you're still living in slavery and you don't even realize it. You're a slave to sin. So therefore, when you open up your mind and your hearts to God, then you'll be able to realize that you're not really in slavery. You see what I'm saying? That slavery is nothing compared to the slavery of sin that's gonna, if you don't put it in check and get it out your life, you gonna find yourself by yourself. Okay, so just like I said, remember, this is a spiritual channel. So all my outlooks is always gonna be on a spiritual level. And I'm not here to defend nobody. This is my channel. So far, YouTube has not kicked me off, and I've been on here for many years. So do not judge a book by its cover. This young lady was there, and she had this stuck-up attitude, whatever it had. And I was talking to my daughter, I said, see, this doesn't make no sense. I was sitting there waiting and waiting. I was waiting and waiting. And I just had the feeling that she was ignoring me. And it's not like she was waiting. I really can't remember whether she was waiting on someone. But all I was paying attention to was the vibe she was giving. And I was like, this don't make no sense. And you know what's saying, folks? Our favorite line is, oh, I'm so glad I'm saved. So glad the Lord saved me. Because, just like I said one time in my message, whenever you start saying that, you better check yourself. Because now you in the flesh. If you got to keep reminding yourself that you're glad that God saved you, then you have not overcome that part of the flesh. Can I get an amen for myself? Okay. So now, I sat there though, patiently. Or should I say I stood there patiently. So finally, it was our turn. So now, to make that story short, and get back to this video. She turned out to be very nice. And I guess she knew, or she caught on to my vibe as well. And she said, see? I don't know, I can't really remember whether she said, see, you shouldn't be judging a book by its cover. No, she said, see? And you thought, I'm paraphrasing, and you thought that I was ignoring you, and you thought that I didn't want to help you and stuff like that. She was saying in that sort of manner. And me and Danielle looked at each other like, She was paying attention to us. But it didn't look like she was paying attention. It looked like, just like I said, it looked like she was ignoring us. But apparently, her college days and years taught her the business administration of how to ignore people, but still wait on them. You know what I'm saying? Don't let a person demeanor define who you are. Okay? So, she turned out to be a very nice person, and she picked this ring. I explained to her what I wanted. And she said, all right, come and get this one. Then you go buy this one. And she picked another ring, which I never went back and got. So, and she was like, come back and get this one. She's like, 'cause this one be nice. And that one was like, okay. That one was sort of like this. But the little skinny silver part was a little bit thicker. 'Cause all they rings are still in silver. And it was white gold with, I'm trying to picture in my head. It was white gold where the silver part was, that was white gold. It was a bit thicker. And it was, I think it had like a little piece that came up, like it's holding this diamond, like it's holding it. It had a little piece that came up that gathered that hold it. A diamond in the middle. So their rings, majority of their rings is stackable. So you are able to buy different rings and stack. You see how I got these stacked? This is called stacking. Putting rings on top of another. So you can make your own wedding set and stuff. So okay. So that's what this is. And then this bottom ring. This bottom ring is actually gold. You can't really tell because it needs to be clean. But it's gold. I think it's platinum, gold over sterling silver, something like that. But anyway, those are diamonds in the middle. They're so little. No, baby girl. I don't have the money to be making them. Making them big, gigantic diamonds. I have to save up for it. Okay? I have to save up for it. So now, so this ring, you can't really see it. Let me see if I can go. You can't really see it, but it's a bit, it's not that thick, but it's thick. And there's little tiny diamonds. There's tiny diamonds up in here. And it goes to a set. So at that time, I was into my little three ring set. So this is a three ring set. It got this one, and it has a diamond. I think it got a little diamond, a little small, same kind of gold, but real tiny, and a little ring. Engagement. Okay, so now I'm going to go to this finger. Okay. So now, this is a set. This is platinum silver. Platinum over sterling silver. And in the middle, it also is a set. I just put a guard on this ring, and that man really guarded this one. It's really tight. I just put a guard on it. So it got like, you got like a few tiny diamonds in it. You see. You can't really see. But it's sterling silver. But anyway, this is the one. This is another one. This has its own set. This is only two sets. So the other diamond, the engagement ring that goes to this one, is round.